Ivy's fan finally found my video and fixed that glitch. So you only have 1 hour each day if you didn't buy the lessons. There are 3 options that you can do to keep using Ivy's fan for free. First, use the old version when the trick still works. Second, use this speed hack thing. And third, if you want to use the latest version, you can just change the date so the timer will reset. Now, this first option is probably the easiest. You will not missing out too much with this older version compared to the new one. The first thing you need to do is to download the installer for that older version. I have uploaded it to Google Drive. Simply open the link in the description below. Just hit the download icon on the top right corner and press download again. Save it to any place. This installer is directly taken from Microsoft Store server, so it's 100% safe. It's still version 12.15, just one version before the update that broke this timer reset trick. After finish downloading, you can click it directly on your browser download list to run the installer, or manually find the file like me. I save it on my desktop. It will be shown as Windows Application Package. Then simply double click it to install Ivy's Fan. It will open this window. If you already installed the new Ivy's Fan, you will see this message. Just click reinstall and you want to downgrade it to 12.15. And the process itself only took 1 second. You can click launch to open up Ivy's Fan directly. And then you can see it's on version 1.12.5. Try to make a new canvas first before continue to the next step. And no need to close Ivy's Fan, just keep this open. Now we can reapply the same trick for the timer, but this time it's much easier to follow. Open up the description of this video and copy this user profile text on the step 1. Select this one line and press Ctrl C or right click and copy. And follow the process, press Windows plus R on your keyboard. This small window will appear on the bottom left. Then just press Ctrl V and enter. And it will instantly open the session folder that you need. Super easy, just like removing a cheat code of the game. So no more comments saying you can't find this folder. Right click on this session 1 file and choose properties. Click the read only and just click OK. And you are done. You have installed the older version and applied the trick that will still work. If you can't follow the Windows R thing, then try manually find your Ivy's Fan folder. Press Windows and E to open File Explorer directly. Go to C, your Windows installation partition. Open User folder. Find your username on your computer. For me, it's Idair. I don't know why it's missing an O. And then the Ivy's Fan folder is here. Just scroll down a bit. Open it and you will find all your artwork file here. And also the session folder. So now after you set it to read only properly, you can just draw peacefully. And if you get this jump scare, simply go back to gallery view and back to the main blue menu where you see the Ivy's Fan logo. No need to close Ivy's Fan entirely. Then open your work again. You see timer is back at 15 minutes, the time when I set the file to read only. This doesn't stop your timer entirely, only reset back after you go back to the main menu. You probably don't have a full 60 minutes, like here I only have 15 minutes. But don't worry, you will have full 60 minutes on the next day. It's not full only for this day, and it's not permanent. If you don't have enough time, or if you already ran out the timer before you set it to read only, you can just set your date to the next day. This will be explained on the next option. I have tried this on 3 different laptops and it's all working. So if it doesn't work for you, check your session file again. Make sure it's already read only and hit OK or apply. Both are the same. And make sure you are already on correct version and disable auto updates to keep it stay on version 12.15. I already linked a guide on that pinned comment on older video, but I will show it here. First, press Windows key on your keyboard or just click on the Windows icon on the bottom text bar and then type in Store or Microsoft Store. Click that Microsoft Store to open it. Then click on your profile icon on the top right and click on Settings. The first line is App Update. Uncheck it to disable auto updates. this will disable auto updates on all apps you install from Microsoft Store. The only downside of this older version is you cannot open EBSPN file from the newer version. When you try to edit it, it say it require the new version, but you still can recover it by exporting it to PSD file and then import it back to EBSPN. Click on the dots on the top right and then save as PSD with preserved layers. Save it on any place you will remember, then find that PSD you just saved. This is the artwork that I just export. Right click on it and choose open with and open it with EBSPN. If you can't find EBSPN on the list, try to find it on choose another app menu. I don't know any other way to import PSD file in EBSPN on PC, so please let me know in the comment. By clicking open with EBSPN, it will open PSD to EBSPN directly and save to your EBSPN. And here you have recovered your old art, but still you can't save the time-lapse replay though. But you still can install the newer version again to recover them all. There is a small chance that the artwork is corrupted like this. You cannot export it as PSD if you have this error. So you will need to update it back to the newest version to fix this and recover your corrupted file. Open up Microsoft Store again and click on Library, the books icon on the left side. In there, you can see all the apps you installed, including EBSPN, and just update it and you will get the newest version back. My store is kinda back here. Super weird. This is worse than Epic Store. Now you can fix the corrupted art and export it to PSD, and maybe save the time-lapse while you still can. EBSPN is just super weird. The good thing with this update and reinstall is you will not lose any of your brushes. To return back to version 12.15, simply redo the installation and it only took a couple seconds. I thought this speed hack thing still works, but it's not working at all. EBSPN become unresponsive with this. You cannot do anything. The menu will not appear after I turn on the speed hack, and you cannot open any layer or the color wheel or anything. Maybe the pop-up animation also run at 0% speed, so it's not appearing. I have wrote entire script explaining how the cheat engine works, its safety and history, and even my experience with it hacking games 10 years ago. I wanted to add this matrix thing here, but well, it's not working. So we only have 2 options, not 3. Let's try the second or the third option. This second option allows you to use the newer version, but it's a bit inconvenient. Simply open your artwork and draw normally till trial limit. Now after you kick out of it, change the date of your laptop or your PC. Look at the bottom right of your monitor. Right click on the date and time, and then just click adjust date and time. You need to turn off the automatic time setting. Now you can change the date. Simply change the day to the next day and next. And then you can try open your artwork again, and you will have a full 60 minutes again. You actually don't need to close EBSPN for this process. See the timer here, it's already on 59 minutes, and then we change the date, and right after we change it, it's going back to 60 minutes again. You can just keep doing this forever. But you cannot use any previous day because EBSPN keep track of all the date you use. So if we change the date to yesterday, it will say the trial time is already over, even though it was still 59 minutes. Another example, if you already use the date to up to 19, and then you go back to the real day 15, EBSPN will not work too. And if you use up to 17 and then jump to 20, you cannot use 18 and 19 even though you haven't used it at all. So all the previous day will not work. Changing the date sometime will make some website not working at all. So you need to reset it back to the real day when you are not using EBSPN. You need to remember which day you use. Well, you can just go to 2077 and it will still work if you forget. If you want to actually reset the day used, you will need to uninstall BSPN, but you will lose all of your process. Simply press Windows key again and type in BSPN, right click on it and uninstall. And then install BSPN again, press Windows key, type store, and open Microsoft Store and find BSPN. Now you can open BSPN again on your used day, reverting back all your data. The downside of uninstalling is you will lose all your settings and browsers. So don't do this if you don't need them. Just keep changing dates and you will be fine. If you are curious why it's not working anymore, it's because they already updated how the session 1 file works. Maybe they finally found my video. Well, it's the first one appeared when you search BSPN on PC. If you search it on Google, so now when we open the drawing, they will delete the file and make a new one. So the read-only property is removed. See the date modified, always get blank, it's time we open the artwork. Other than that, they also make BSPN stop working if we disable all access to this session 1 file. So it's a double protection. I'm not a hacker or anything, and so I have no new method for this. You can survive with just older version or changing the date. By the way, did you know BSPN is actually pronounced as IBIS? I only found this out now. I thought it follow pronunciation like Ibisupain or Ibisupainto. And then I searched for the Japanese text and it turned out it's actually an English word turned to Japanese. So it's not Ibispain, it's
Ibisupainto.
Ibisu. Ibisupainto. This video is probably a bit too late. I found this video on YouTube recommendation right after I finished editing this video, so I will just upload the same video again. Thanks for the shout out anyway.